saying?
Top of the morning. Welcome to Africa. I said, I need to go sit over there by myself for them folk come outside. Everybody around this bitch sleep. Nigga, I'm like, let me get my ass out of here, man. Yeah, y'all stay your ass asleep. Partying all night. Took my ass to sleep last night. Good morning. My true story. Shout out to my Compton niggas, man. Compton Bompton niggas, man. Let's keep it going, man. Independent gang. They don't want you to know about this part of Africa. I need me an apartment down here. Who wanna go half on an apartment with me down here? I ain't gonna be here every day. I'm just gonna come on the weekend. Who wanna go half with me? Yeah, you bring your ass out of, you stay here, and I'm gonna be in Nairobi where the money at. And I'm gonna be back on the weekend. I think I need to do that for real. Nah, real shit. We wanna overlook the ocean. I don't care, it could be a man or a woman. 50-50. Matter of fact, let's get three people. Because I ain't going to be here all the time. I got work to do. Now, I'm going to take my shoes off for sure. I'm going to put my shorts back on. Now, I got on jeans, nigga. It was cold at first in my room. I came outside. Like, wait a minute, it's hot out this bitch. I'm going to put them shorts back on, baby. Y'all gotta make sure my people see this shit. Yeah, that's what this about. All my hood niggas, it's time to take a vacation from the hood for a few days. You hear me? Anybody that's in here watching me and you be in the hood every day, at a certain point, you gotta take a break. I ain't saying you gotta come to Africa, but I'm just saying you gotta take a break. You can't be around that shit all the time, bro. That shit start fucking with your head. It start fucking with my head anyway. Oh, I gotta get the fuck away from these niggas, man. Shit me. Nigga, I don't care how many guns you got. Nigga, that shit right there, man. Guns don't mean nothing. You live with them, you die with them. Same thing. You know what I mean? They don't want a nigga. They don't, like, we got to live our life, but it's like, man, that hood shit just every day, nigga, murder plots. Every day, you know, you just don't know what's going on. You got to stay far out the shit as you can, man. Yeah. Since it's just the time when it kicks down, thinking of a plan to get quick bands, falling in deep with the quick sand. True story. Leaving to Santa Cruz, that's right. That's right, take your ass to Santa Cruz, man. True story. I feel you, bro. Ain't nothing wrong with leaving all the negative energy, man. Places where just number negative energy, get away from that shit as soon as you can, bro. I promise you, y'all won't see me hanging out with hoods the same way ever again. What the fuck I'm hanging out for? If I ain't there for something specific, I won't be there. Yeah, real shit, nigga. I learned to maneuver. When I go back to America, that's why you don't see me posting. I'm over here with these niggas. I'm with them niggas. Nah, I ain't with no niggas. If you see me take a picture with somebody, it's because, nigga, we fuck with each other for real. But, like, just going in the hood like I used to, because I was making movies. I had to. Nigga, I gambled my life many a night. 3 a.m. in somebody else's hood. With some niggas like, come on, Feed. You know everybody know Feed gonna come. But when I be in America now, I got to really love you niggas to be in your hood, man. True story. I better my chances for staying out of trouble. I better my chances. Even when I went to San Francisco, I was in my hood every day, but niggas didn't see me. Because I wasn't getting out, standing on blocks. I'm like, nah, nigga, y'all wasn't fucking with me, nigga, when I was going through my shit. Don't fuck with me now. I'm going to show you that I'm right here, but I don't fuck with you, niggas. You don't fuck with me, I don't fuck with you neither, nigga. Yeah, nigga, just like that. Nigga, my hood going to forever be my hood, but there ain't nothing there for me. I don't even got no family that live in Fillmore. My son, the only one be there, nigga. And I'm like, shit, that's on him. Yeah, that's on him. He don't have to be there, but he be there because he want to. So therefore, nigga, have fun, nigga. I ain't got nothing to do with whatever happening out there, nigga. Nothing. Told my son, stay the fuck away from out there. Now you got access to the whole world. So if you choose to be right there and some right there shit happen to you, you ask for it. Yup, you asked for it, nigga. You could escape it, nigga. So whoever know my son, tell him I said it, nigga. Every chance I get, I'ma say something, whether he like it or not. Cause I need this on public record that I warned my son, nigga. That nigga is in the motherfucking valley of the shadow of death, nigga. Straight up, with a bunch of niggas he think is his niggas. So I'm saying it publicly, nigga. Nigga, go for yourself, be by yourself, nigga. Yeah. But you know we hard-headed, we gonna do what we want. Yeah, so you go ahead, little hardhead son, just in case you is. I don't know what he doing. But I like to say this shit publicly. Yeah, you have a chance to be around the world, nigga. You ain't got to come to Africa with me. You could be anywhere. Get the fuck out of Fillmore. That bitch curse, nigga. That bitch curse. That bitch cursed, nigga. The whole hood, nigga. That hood shit is cursed, nigga. Death after death after death after death after death after death. Over something that happened in 1998. Death after death after death after death after death. Niggas keep adding themselves to the cycle of death, 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 death. So that's why I be trying to tell other people. Maybe my son might not listen, but somebody else's son listen. Hey, nigga, the other niggas out there. Get your ass away from that shit. If you got a chance to make other plays, doing something else. I know you want to be around all the shit, huh? When you stuck in it, I understand. If you really, you know, you might owe somebody some money. Or maybe you joined a gang and they got the right to tell you, you can't go. Hey, bro, I'm trying to go. You know, I'm about to leave for a few months. Nah, homie, you can't do that. You joined us, nigga. You got, nigga, this blood in, blood out. Nigga. I'm glad I never joined no nigga gang to be able to tell me what to do. What? Yeah, homie, you can't go. You can't what? Boy, you sound crazy, man. I'm about to go way somewhere else and get the fuck away from you niggas, man. I'm about to go somewhere else, man. I don't need to be around you. Fuck that. Oh, no, I already caught them, family. No, I been caught them. I ain't gonna keep calling, though. Everybody gotta learn the hard way. I wish I had a father. Especially one like me. I'll be it, boy. Teach me something, Dad. So I could be like you. Fuck you mean. Real shit. Young nigga swag. Nah, real talk. Happy to be here, man. Happy to be here. R.I.P. to all my niggas that didn't make it, bro. I got niggas that didn't make it to 25. I got niggas that didn't never see 30. I miss them niggas, but nobody didn't listen. Niggas did not listen, bro. We lost a whole squad of niggas. The main niggas all dead. Now some new younger niggas coming, you know. But the original squad was my squad of niggas that grew up under me. And to see all them die like that, I knew I was like, nigga, I'm not finna give my life to this shit, nigga. What the fuck? I gotta tell the streets. Hey, bro, before you give your life to the hood, because a lot of niggas, you know what we say? Shit, live by, die by it. And get else we say? shit, nigga, when I go out, nigga, I'm going out right here. I'm like, see, nigga, already planning their death. Ask a real street nigga right now, dude, is some of them words come out his mouth? Nigga, live by it, die by it. Shit, nigga gonna die anyway, right? Yeah, I'm gonna die like a G. I say that too. I'm like, nigga, but I don't wanna die out there like a G. No. Not for the hood. I mean, for me as a man. Not for no hood shit, nigga. The hood ain't adding up right now, nigga. The hood is not paying us good. Nigga, we is paying a heavy price living the hood life and not thinking bigger. It's not even adding up no more. We cut our blessings out. If God was supposed to bless the black community because he's God and he could bless who he want, he looking at what we doing to ourselves and he like, I came to save y'all and I'm here to help y'all. And nobody thinking about that I'm watching. And nobody ain't saying that y'all killing each other by the thousands. Boom, 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 bow, bow, bow. Boom, 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 bang, bang, bang. It got to be a price tag for that. And all the black people, us, we just look the other way. Shit, that ain't my business. Yeah, nigga, because we ain't about, can't, man, listen, we not finna tell the police who did it, why. Because, nigga, we gonna die. You can't tell the police nothing. Nigga, I wanna live, nigga. We not telling the police nothing. Is you hearing me? So I understand that we can't use the police to save us, but we got to talk. I don't know, man. It got to be somewhere the black people talk to the black people. But I don't know if it's enough black people care. Motherfucker be like, man, shit, let them niggas die. Have you ever heard somebody say that? Yeah, these young brothers killing them. Man, let them kill each other. Man, get rid of these niggas, man, because they ain't going to listen. True story. Shout out to the OGs, but y'all can't leave us behind. I'm not. I know the young generation need my help. Not need, but could use my help. They don't need me, but they could use my help, though. Yup. Nah, real talk. Man, people, they backdoing each other's back-to-back right now. Fuck that shit. I don't need no friend that's going to sell me out. I don't need to even be with nobody, man. Anybody watch my journey, you looking at a lonely man. You looking at a lonely guy. But I'd rather be lonely and successful, nigga, than goddamn unlonely and dead. Unlonely, got plenty fake love, plenty friends around. I don't even give people that much access to me. If I do, it's full strangers. Did you hear me? I'd rather get some strangers access to me than the people that I know. Why? The snake shit. They can say what they want about me. They talk about me all the time. I'll be like, shit, nigga, I'm doing good by myself, nigga. I told you I didn't need no nigga with me. Yeah, you don't, we ain't fucking with you. Boy, I don't need you niggas. Have you ever heard niggas say they don't fuck with me? Yeah, we ain't supporting Fig. We ain't with Fig. That's a bunch of niggas, right? I'll be like, boy, I don't need not one of you niggas. But I'm way on the other side of the world, man, busting plays, nigga. See, I proved it. Well, God proved it. By letting me. I can't say I proved it. God opened every door for me to be able to prove it. In flesh. Y'all watch my pain. You can watch this channel. Go to the first post and just go up. I post everything I do so it won't be nobody talking about, oh, he just got lucky. No, he didn't get lucky. That nigga worked for that. I'm really just getting started. You just now starting to see what I've been working on is like, it's something over here. People know me over here now. They talk quicker over here. Hey, the American. Ain't no other American nigga like me over here. In Burkina Faso, wasn't no American nigga like me. And in goddamn Kenya, the whole country, it ain't no nigga like JT, nigga. Ain't no, when I say nigga like me, meaning a rap nigga that already did something in America, that's over here now. Everybody who did something over there, they still over there. I'm the first one to take my motherfucking, my accolades from America and came over here. And they like, oh, that's you? See, they happy to see me. But the nigga from over there, oh, that's just Fig. I already know him. Who was that, JT? Oh, I been saw him already. Fuck you, nigga. Nah, much love to my old school people, though. I'm like, who, Pete? I already know him. Who's that, little baby? Oh, yeah. You know, your partner go crazy for little baby. You come back to town, they be like, who, Pete? I already seen him. Laugh with them niggas, too, though. Now, I knew I was going to get the last laugh. Why? Nigga, I got some new customers. They ain't got nothing to do with you niggas over here. Promise you that. Nigga, from little kids to old people in their 90s. The American? Play that song again. I'm like, an old nigga want to hear my music? They done fucked up now. Nigga, I got old people want to hear my shit, nigga. Have you ever seen a village of old people playing your music doing this? I'm like, what the fuck? I got to get it on video. People in their 80s, nigga, like this. Shout out to my mama Pearl for having me, man. Thank you, mama Pearl. I hope I make her proud. She told me, I can make this announcement. I told my mama, I said, I got finished some more work over here in Africa, and I hope God bless me so I can make you proud. She was like, son, I'm already proud. I got to smile about that. You know, me and my mama was kind of like beefing, or I was beefing. Well, I don't know if she was beefing or me. I don't know. One of us was beefing. I don't even know who it was. But she is not. Work it out with your mama, y'all. Yep. So when she say, son, I'm already proud. I was like, yeah, I like that right there. Now I got to really go hard so she could be more proud. Fuck you mean. Till I'm dead, mama. Till you go or I go, goddamn, I got to do this for us and show you. You know what I mean? I ain't no wasted son because I was hella bad when I was young. Police coming to the house, all them jail shit. I thought she hated me. Like, I would have hated me. You in jail again? Get your ass away from me. Get away from me. Have you ever been to jail as a kid? Your mama like, hello, Miss Pearl. We got your son over here again. What the fuck did they call my mama all them times? I would have hated me. I ain't the only one like that. There's other niggas like that too. Don't act like it's just me. Did your mama hate you at one point? What the fuck you do? Oh, shit. No, I'm just saying though. So salute to everybody who working it out with their mamas and shit. Some people, they got a good relationship with their mama. I be wanting that same thing. Is that a fucking monkey walking by? Bro, is this a monkey sitting right there? That nigga just walked out of nowhere. That nigga, the fuck? He's like a fucking cat monkey. Like a fucking cat. Have you ever seen a cat monkey? Yeah, work it out with moms. Work it out, work it out, work it out. All people work it out with moms. Haven't seen mama since I went to the penitentiary. That's what I'm saying, y'all. Talk to moms, call her. Send her something, man. As much as I think it's my birthday, it's really my mama's birthday. Because she the one who had me. So she add this date to her date. Oh, man, here go hella monkeys coming up. Is they about to attack? Nigga done caught his cousin, his brother. I was just making a sound. I ain't feeding time. Or is it? See, I've been to Africa, but I don't really be around like animals and shit, except chickens and some cows and some sheep and goats. But monkeys and camels and shit, I ain't been around this. Yep. Yeah, what's happening? You say you got the real Africans in here. Yeah, blessings, man. We only get one mama, man. Blessings, blessings, blessings. Tell my Africans out there in the Uber I send my love. Yeah. I always had good relationship with my African people. Because I always looked at the African people like me. I never really looked at them like something separate. I just said they got another country to go to. We didn't have no another country. That's the only thing I could say. But I never looked at it as like different. True story. Yeah, these motherfuckers got it laid out. Man, why that bitch 20 feet right there? I'm definitely finna go jump in this bitch. This shit right here, though. I needed this right here, though. I promise you I needed to do this. Because I be in the hood so much, I be, you know, everything I do out here, I be in the hood so much. So they're like, you know, you could take a $50 airplane flight for 1 hour away and go to the beach. Just go to the beach. I'm like, what the hell? $50? $50? So $100 round trip ticket. Yeah, and go to the, and they got plenty of hotels, just pick one. Nah, nigga, what's a good one? I need to be at the one where, nigga, the good one. So this is what they recommended for me. They got a little shit going on in this motherfucker. They got them restaurants thing going. They got the little dance little thing going over there, yeah, so they got something. The room's pretty cool. This is the first hotel I've been to without no TV. They're like, no, we don't do TV here. We want you to enjoy the resort. I say, man, but what if I want to see CNN? Like, no CNN here. This is where you would just enjoy the nature. I say, oh, is that a way to save money? Or you really just want me to be? Because I like to watch CNN, man. No CNN here. You must just enjoy. Shout out to Africa on this one. I'm going to give him a pass. This bitch is nice, too. Like, we don't want you to be in room. We need you out here. Come here. Yes, you didn't come pay to be in room. They say, damn, man. What do you mean, bro? Come on, bro. Nah, he was serious, though. He meant every word he said. So I bring my ass outside. Stay out here till nighttime. Yeah, it's cool, though. So I had to do my little report for y'all. I'm going to keep y'all updated as I go through the day. Yeah, that's what Instagram is for. Did you know Instagram is for what I'm doing right now? Yep. And YouTube and Facebook. Yep. Content. I'm posting that shit. I'm posting that shit. Posting that shit. Update. Update. Hey, so y'all be smooth out there. Boy, niggas thought I was crazy. This the first trip, I think, where niggas could see, like, maybe Fig wasn't crazy going over there. Because I just see you in, like the slums. I think, you know, I thought that's all they had. Nah. You should calm down, little buddy. I told you, I just ain't came out here to kick it, nigga. I need to do work. I didn't want you to see me doing this first. I needed to see me in the projects, in the slums, in the ghetto. In the barrio. Nigga, you need to see me over there first. Then you can see this. See, this is when, after you do the hood shit, now you get to do the good shit. Because it's work before play. In America, we gonna play and keep playing until the money run out. You know it and I know it. In America. In Africa, they scared to spend their last money on doing some shit like this. But a black American, we on our way to Miami, nigga, or Acapulco, Puerto Rico. Bro, you need to make an investment. No, fuck an investment. Me and my old lady or my girl or whoever. Yeah, we on our way to goddamn Cancun. So you finna go do a $5,000-$10,000 play. Because y'all gonna spend money, have fun, pop bottles, do all the good shit. Bro, you should've opened up your store, my nigga. You should've ordered your clothes that you say you're selling. You should've ordered some more shirts first. You got your shirt business. You got a car wash business. You supposed to bought another generator, another power washer. You big dummy. come on, nigga, you can't spend money first. So in Africa, they definitely taught me that. They teaching me that little by little. JT, we not buying nothing like that. Oh, JT, we don't do that here. I'm like, oh, y'all don't do that? They're like, no. I'm going to buy 4 more cows. Nigga then bought 4 more cows, nigga, in 6 months to a year. Nigga, he finna cash out on 4 cows. Then you got another nigga finna do 22 goats, and he finna add 22 more goats, nigga. He'll spend his whole amount of money. I say, why did he just do that? Like, why he didn't sell them ones first? He like, nah, out here, nigga, your money based on how much shit you got to sell. That is the money. He got 44 goats. I say, what the fuck? I need 44 goats. Nigga, how much is that worth? It all depends how you want to chop the meat down. You know, this shit based on meat. You know, a nigga could take one goat, chop that thing down, right? And make, like, maybe triple the money of what he's selling it for whole. Because he finna bust down them pound prices and quarter pound, you know. Look at this nigga come. Did this nigga just come walk by me? Little buddy, what is you doing? That nigga look like a cat monkey. Now, this nigga then walked over there. So, y'all just coming out. So, y'all out today. Y'all hanging out today. God damn it, that nigga really walked over here. Yeah, so back to my goat business. Don't be shocked if you see me with my goats. And all of them gonna say JT on it, because every time when somebody buy goats, they put their name on it. So you gonna see the JT goats. I want black ones, white ones. I want the black and white ones. Speckled goat. Yeah, I want the one with the dots on their face, nigga. Then I want the nigga with the beard, with the two horns. Yeah, I want a good one. Daddy goat, papa goat. Yep, he gonna get all the ladies pregnant. Give me a good batch. A little baby speckled goats with the horns. Ramming shit. Niggas ramming shit. The real goats. Oh, man. Shoot, 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 shoot. Y'all tell that nigga shoot. Now they jumping. Shoot, shoot. Oh, they pretty scary. Y'all definitely ain't no gorillas. These niggas definitely ain't no baby gorillas. Tell that nigga, if you don't get your ass away from me, if you don't get your ass away from me, that nigga finally understood. If you don't get your ass away from me, he seen my cup, he like, oh, he put his cup down. It must be something in it. No, not in this cup. Yeah, there's still something. They'll run off with your phone. You might not never see it again. If that monkey get your phone, he didn't hit that tree to that tree to that tree, you will not find him. You will definitely need GPS. You will definitely need GPS. Now, they told you that. Don't get a monkey's nothing. Them niggas will snatch your keys to your car. Now, him and his buddies, they swinging vine to vine way down there. You don't know where they went. You don't know if he dropped the fucking keys. Did he take them with him? Yes, yeah, it's just a nightmare. They was looking, but I'm on them boys. Oh, yeah, man, the Africa shit. I think what make this Africa shit more interesting when you watch me, that you know I'm from there, but I live here. So let's see if JT do good, then maybe we could do good. Because I think that's what this is about, too. It took somebody who's willing to take a chance of coming over here. It's a chance. You take a chance. You know? It wasn't no guarantee for me to make it over here. It still ain't no guarantee. Is that my work I'm putting in is giving me a better chance. Yeah, it's giving me a better chance right now. It's giving me a better chance at success right now. You got to take a chance first, right? When you start your first business, you're going to take a chance. You might got an inheritance. You might be using your life savings. You might be using your check money from your job. And you about to spend it on something for your independent business. Nothing is guaranteed except what you make it be guaranteed. So that means if something don't go right when it first starts, you don't supposed to quit. You supposed to keep going anyway. You know what I mean? Real shit. Now, that's what I'm saying. I'm telling people, you had to do it. Look, adapting to the environment, once you learn how to buy your groceries, once you know where the pharmacy at to get something if you need for pharmacy, once you know where to go for your entertainment, once you know how the transportation work in the country, once you know where a doctor is at, the dentist is at, once you know how to ship a package and receive a package, once you know where the airport is at, man, you can live there. Once you got them few different things right there, man, I done learned how to live anywhere out here, man, where the doctor's at, where the food at, where this at, where that, how far is it from the house, where the house is at, what's the best area, boom, 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 nigga, just like if you move to Atlanta right now, don't move in goddamn Thomasville. We have apartments for $450 in Atlanta. You don't know nothing about it, you better Google it. Nigga, them apartments, everybody house get broken in. Nigga, your house, you just a new guy in town. Your family, the newest family that's gonna come home with everything. They don't tell you that in the advertisement. We have a break-in problem. So you gotta Google that shit. Or you gotta talk to some natives that really know. Nah, it's cool around here, or no, it's not cool around here. All right? So coming to Africa is the same thing. You gotta meet somebody. Once you meet one person, they can take you to another person. If you smart, you getting everybody name and number added to your phone. True story. True story. I see you, Macadon. Blessings, my G. Yeah. I done got hit in Atlanta a couple times. Yeah, but I'm the new nigga in town. I was anticipating it. I was anticipating nigga to get hit. Thank God it wasn't nothing that just shut me all the way down, but I took losses though. Like, motherfucker got me. Shit. So, in Africa, I just kind of try to protect my shit a little better knowing that I come from America. If they get you in America, they'll get you in Africa if you slipping. If you put yourself in a position, if you move into the wrong area, if you ain't got the right people watching your shit, all of them elements play a part in if you're going to get hit or not. They got places where I live at right now in Nairobi. Nigga, they don't want nobody coming around there messing up fucking with the clients, nigga, because that's fucking up their money. In America, they not smart enough to hire some fucking patrol cars or something. You know, security guard, arms, nigga with guns. Hey, y'all got to move from right here. They not smart enough to do that. They keep all the rent money and they not putting none of it back into protecting the people who live in apartment complexes in America. Only some of them do that. Well, you got niggas with guns walking around. Hey, y'all can't sell dope right here. Hey, you can't keep your, you know, you can't gangbang right here. You can't do none of that right here, nigga. You is not fucking up our complex. They got some people that take that shit serious. But 90% of the fucking apartment complexes, you pretty much on your own. That's why everybody got a gun, and it just be shootouts back to back. So I'm throwing it out there about Africa, what I've learned in these 2 years. You know I'm on my third year out here now, right? I'm officially in my third year today, October 7th. 2019, my start starts today. So I'm 1 month in. October 7th, November 7th, tomorrow the 7th, I'm tripping. Tomorrow the 7th. Yeah, tomorrow I'll be 1 month into my third year. See, I keep track of my dates to see if I'm doing good or am I fucking up. Am I doing good or am I doing bad? Okay, I need to step it up here. I need to tone it down there. I need to turn it up right here. All them elements is for my students who watch me, because if you study me, you are my student. Not my personal student, but you a student of the game. Pay attention. Progress you must measure. All that kicking and hanging and nigga, hanging and going on dates so much. See, some of you niggas is date masters. You're always on a date. You're always buying a new outfit. You're always getting fresh. You're always going to be, yeah, nigga, you ain't got to go to, you on vacation in your city. Your date closed, Friday closed, Saturday closed, something to switch up Sunday. You know, you got your hotel suite, you know, you got your bottles. You need to stop right quick. Nigga, get straight on business and call it discipline. All right, baby girl, I ain't finna be taking you on dates all the time right now. What's wrong, man? Hey, calm down, baby. We ain't doing this shit every weekend no more right now. I got some shit I gotta do. Yup, I'm finna turn it off for a minute, for about 2 weeks. I gotta go straight all gas, no brakes business. Hey, are you gonna leave me? Tell me now.